Well, this is a regular season Group B game. Should be a good one, folks. Athodor Saratov, impressive last week. Just held on. They open up a big lead at Kimmich. And then they battled back. Well, Athodor Saratov winning last week at BC Kimmich in Ukraine, and Kataya Basket, they were at home against Rishon from Israel, and Kataya Basket lost that game 72-64. So Maccabi Rand Media winning at Kataya Basket last week. They'll be looking to bounce back, and it's going to be a tough game to get a win at Athodor Saratov, but they'll come out all guns blazing, hopefully for the fans of the Finnish club, and they'll come out and get the job done. Well, good evening, folks. If you're just joining us, we're in Saratov, Russia. It's the Basketball Champions League. It's the second week, and Kataya Basket hoping to bounce back from last week's home loss to Maccabi Rand Media. Here's their lineup, coached by Greg Gibson, and they had a big game last week from Daniel Mullins, who had 15 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists, 4 steals, 3 blocks. He really couldn't have done much more. So they'll be hoping for more of the same from him. But hopefully for Kataya Basket fans, he'll get a little bit of help. As for Athodor Saratov, well, it was an interesting game at Kimmich. Tomislav Zubcic really came up big, started hitting a lot of jump shots in that game. Brandon Frazier was big early on, and they got some solid performances. Our team, Klimenko, Maxim Koliushkin, all the way up and down that roster. They opened up a big lead at Kimmich, and then they kind of held on at the end for an important win, because you don't want to leave it too long to get a win in these European competitions. And if you can get a win on the road, it's all the better. So Kataya Basket, having lost at home, have traveled not really that far away into Russia, and they'll try to get on the winning track.
Команда Автодор Саратов, Россия. Номер 5, Томислав.
All the Athodor Saratov players being introduced here to the crowd.
Номер 8, Брэндон Фрейзер. Номер 12, Артём Клименко.
And as we look at these guys coming out, it's just a reminder that we had a couple of qualifying rounds to get into the regular season, and Kataya Basket had to win in the second qualifying round to book their place in this regular season in the competition. They went up against Södertälje Kings from Sweden, and they were convincing winners. Huge first leg win, then they also hit the road and lost by 7 points, but they had already opened up a 39-point advantage over the two legs from the first leg. So we've got 40 teams in the regular season, 280 games will be played in the regular season. This is week two. All these teams aiming to get into the elimination round.
делегация, technical delegate of the game, Mikhail Davidov, Russia.
And more on the competition in just a minute. First, let's take a look at tonight's referees. And they will come from Poland, Latvia, and Montenegro. Marek Malajewski, Martins Kozlowskis, and Vladimir Vojinovic. So how do you get to the elimination round? Well, 24 teams will advance to the playoffs, or the elimination round, the four top teams from each group and the four best ranked fifth place teams. The five group winners and three best ranked second place teams will advance directly to playoffs round two. The rest of the 16 teams will face each other in eight pairings, home and away, with the winner to playoffs round two. And in that playoffs round two, you have 16 teams playing home and away. So you'll end up having four teams at the final four. So Kataya coach Greg Gibson going over his notes here before the game, perhaps making sure he's got the right lineup that he submitted to the table. This after tour team had an interesting game last week at Kimmich. They opened up a 10-point lead at the end of the first quarter, went to halftime up by 11, and then it was a matter of just kind of hanging on, and they really did just hang on at the end. Kimmich had possession, and they could have tied it with a three, but they missed, and Sergei Mulkin's team, there's the coach for Aftador, they walked off the court winners. So they will know they had a narrow escape in that game. And when they look back at it, they'll remember they got some solid play, especially from Zucic and Frazier, each who finished with efficiency ratings of 21, which led the team. And also Nicholas Minarev had an efficiency rating of 19. He scored 18 points. Zucic had the 19 to lead the way in the scoring. Brandon Frazier had the 15 points, 8 rebounds, and 8 assists. So he had just a terrific all. And Zupcic also had those 9 rebounds to go with his 19 points. Koliushkin came off the bench and had 10 points and 3 assists. And the evaluation, or the efficiency evaluation, of 11. But for Kataya Basket, last week at home against Maccabi Ran Media, they had the big game from Daniel Mullings. 15 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists, 4 steals, 3 blocks. Any coach would take that. They also had a big game from Wesley. Wesley had a team high 23 points and also corralled 11 rebounds.
I think maybe a horse down the next way.
Okay.
We'll call it.
Come on, fellas, let's go.
So keep an eye on Byron Wesley and Daniel Mullings, and we'll see if they can have the same, a similar impact today that they had last week. But they need some other guys to step up, including the likes of Teemu Ranikko. Thank you. Well, good evening, folks, and welcome to Saratov, Russia. It's the Basketball Champions League, and it's the game between Avtodor Saratov and Kataya Basket. And wearing the blue is Kataya Basket, and they're trying to bounce back from last week's home loss. And Ranico going up against Michael Stockton. And if you think you recognize that name, well, it's the son of the legend himself, John Stockton. Pass outside, and a good start here for Kataya Basket. Joey King drilling the long one. Pass over to Minerath. Now Stockton. Shot clock down to five. Minerath is going to put it up, and it's going to hit the back of the rim and bounce out of bounds. So Ranico brings it up the floor. And Ranico puts it up, and Minerath with the rebound. And now the penetration, the drive, and Brendan Fraser, just like he did last week, takes matters into his own hands and gets an early trip to the line for a possible three-point play. Fraser misses the free throw, and Kataya Basket bring it back up the floor. And the long one from Kataya Basket, no good. And a long one for Avtodor Saratov is good. Not a long one, but the basket. Well, indeed, Kolesnikov. Did he hit a three or not? Looking at our graphic. And now the turnover, that triggers a break. And Kolesnikov can't control it. It goes out of bounds, back over to Kataya Basket. Getting it inside was Nino Johnson, and he missed a relatively easy attempt. Now Stockton drives in and gets it to fall. Now Nino Johnson again follows up the miss and scores, puts it up with the left hand. Quick pass inside, and Stockton scores again. Sneaks in there and scores with a little reverse layup. And Saratov have gone on top 8-5. Three-point shot is good. Another one for Joey King. That was Atepertu. So that knocks it at 8 apiece. And this time the jump shot falls for Saratov. So Stockton off to a flying start. Well, answering was Mullings for Kataya Basket. Minerath now tries to bull his way down low. And unable to control it was our team, Klemenko. Now the turnover. So back to Aftador Saratov. Jump shot from the arc, goes in and comes out. So neither of these sides shy about putting up the long one. Wesley off target. Now the pass to Minerath, he goes up. And Klamenko with the rebound. He goes up, misses. And Nino Johnson comes down with the basketball. Raniko. I believe that was King that hit that last three-pointer for some reason. Atepertu appeared. And Klamenko drives in and misses the dunk. Well, that might get him a seat on the bench from Sergei Mokin. Look at this. How does he miss from this close range? You have got to put that one down or you're going to sit down. Michael Carrera is going to check into the game. Wesley gets it into the corner to Vranico. And inside, boy, pretty tough foul there. Well, that's what you get when you go up for the pump fake. And it was Tomi Uolila who picked up the foul. Now he breaks the free throw. And missed both. So missed opportunity. Inside to Minerath, and he puts it up and in. Oh, Raniko has it, the veteran, puts up a three, and now the rebound is back to Brendan Frazier. And he's going to turn it over back to Kataya Basket. A good play by the veteran Raniko. Elevation there, the miss, but following it up was Tomi Uolila, and Kataya giving as good as they get right now. It's an even game. So that was Byron Wesley getting inside, missing, and Uolila was there for the rebound. Zubcic in the game, number five. And Kolyushkin also has come in. He missed that shot. Kataya basket with Raniko. And it rattles out. Minerath for three. Well short. Ball bounces around and ends up with Tomi Uolila. Excuse my finish. Wolila. Wesley to Raniko. And Wolila tries to power his way up but misses. Now Frazier. Frazier. Pass back to Menorath. Carrera from the left corner. Good! Saratov with a, Atador Saratov with a 3-point lead. And now it's back down to one. Shot from Sepela. Irari Sepela. Now Nicholas Minareth turns, puts it up, denied. And Koliushkin looks over at the ref, wanting a foul, but referee just says play on. Now Sepela. Wolila gets into it. So a little bit of contact there with Carrera and Wolila. And actually the foul was called on Wolila. So third team foul, his first personal. Koliushkin passes off to Zubcic. He goes inside. And a big, strong, powerful move that time from the backup center coming in. Shot is good from Koliushkin. Now Wesley drives, hangs, and great fight inside from Katayas. Is that Jericho's Bradley, I think. Lysnikov passes it, and then a foul. So Zavelin is bumped while he's up top. And the pass to Zubcic, and he just puts it up and in. His first two, remember, he led him in scoring last week. Had the 19. And the penetration, the kick. Bradley buries it. And that three-pointer, that could cut into a deficit substantially if those start falling and they only trail Kataya basket behind Atador Saratov, 22-19.
Okay, it's okay. We made 12 points. is it under the basket? Is it feint? Continue with the aim.
Номер восьмой, Брэндон Фрейзер.
Внимание, начинается второй период матча, это 60 секунд, игрок матча впереди.
Well, you heard during the timeout, Kataya basket coach Greg Gibson imploring his players to get ball pressure. Here's Zabelin. Oh, the big fella steps outside and drills the three-pointer. So our team, Zabelin. 25-19. Now the three-point attempt. And Carrera with the rebound. Zabelin this time is fouled. And the foul was on Vesa Makalainen. Carrera gets it into Zupčić, and he tries to pull his way in, and he does. Zupčić takes it to an 8-point lead. Cepala inside. Makalainen passes it back out, and Kataya basket, turn it over. So after Torseradov coming out of that last timeout, starting to put a little distance between themselves and Kataya basket, but Carrera walks. And that'll be a turnover that Greg Gibson will gratefully receive. Zoraniko, a longtime player with Finland's national team. Here's bounce pass inside, and Mullings goes up for the flush with a little bit of authority. Now quickly into the corner. Zupčić gets the loose ball, passes over to Carrera, and the scrap for the rebound, and the foul is going to be called on Saratov, Athodor Saratov. Great job down low, but here was Mullings again. He got the elevation and then just threw it down with a little bit of power. Look at that. And then he went down and got in good rebounding position and drew the foul. But now the turnover by Bradley. And Bradley reaches in and knocks it away. Kolesnikov looks back. Here's Bradley. Came out, hit that three-pointer. Frazier's going to come back in for Kolesnikov. It's 27-21. Zupčić, and well short, and good rebound from Bradley. So Kataya wearing the blue in this week two matchup in the Basketball Champions League. And a little bit of a turnaround jump shot from Bradley, missed everything. Zubcic has it, hands it off to Koliushkin. So top 57% so far, and Kataya 42, and that percentage for Saratov is going to go up after that basket from Koliushkin. Leaders, assists, and steals for Kataya basket. Koliushkin's last shot. That was the wham bam jam, thank you ma'am, from Mullings. So Frazier now back in the game. Flurry of points early on. He's leading the way for Aptador Saratov. 6 points. And three-pointer is good from Radico. Goes back to a six-point game. Stockton back in the game. Now the alley-oop, and it's thrown down big time from Minerath. Now the interception from Carrera. Careless pass from Mullings, and Carrera has earned a trip to the line. You can hear Ranico in Finnish, I think. Certainly wasn't English. Carrera makes both free throws. So positive start for Carrera. And now Aptador Saratov with a 10-point advantage here. 6.5 minutes to go in the first half. And it's a bumping. And it's going to be a foul on Frazier. It'll be the second foul. Look at the alley-oop pass to Minerath. King. To the left, it's good. So Joey King puts one up and in. Now Stockton hands it off to Minerath. Carrera back to Stockton. And a foul on Nino Johnson. By the way, it was Stockton who made that pass to Minerath alley-oop dunk. Now the pass inside to Carrera. He goes up and brings it down and then powers his way up for two. Mullings hands it off to Ranico, and Stockton reached in and committed the foul.
Michael Stockton, number 20, commanded the goal. Second foul, Michael.
Wesley gets in the lane, floats in, puts it up, and a little bit too hard. Now Stockton, no look. Over to Frazier. Bounce pass to Stockton and hangs in the air nicely and puts it up off the glass and in. So now he's got 8 points. Look at that, perfect 4 of 4. And Mullings over to Wesley for 3. Mullings challenges for the rebound. And foul called on Kataya. For the 12-point advantage, Stockton and up, but Menerath this time couldn't quite control it. Nevertheless, Athador get it back, and it's Menerath again, and he draws the foul. So it's going to be even better. I think he'll take this option. He gets the basket and a potential 3-point play. And Vesa Makalainen picks up the foul. Ladies and gentlemen, you do not want to read lips on that one. So, Makalainen heads over to the bench. And this game just starting to get away here from Kataya Basket. Athador really putting the pressure on. Upbeat here as he sends Kataya Basket back out on the court with 4:50 remaining in the second quarter. But Athador Saratov, much like they did at BC. And perhaps it's the home comforts that are helping. But they have a chance to go up by 15, which will be the biggest lead, and they do. So Menerath hits the rim, and then it bounces in. Now Mullings goes strong to the basket and puts it up and in. So Mullings has the potential to do that a lot, you would imagine. Go one-on-one. Now Clamico. So Clamico gets his first 2. And beautiful pass to Nino Johnson from Mullings. And Nino Johnson couldn't finish. No look pass again over to Frazier. Good! Athador Saratov up 46-28. They are blowing this thing wide open here in the second quarter. Boy, they have got a huge number already. And we've got a ways to go before the end of the first half. Ranico. Well, They're off and running at the door, and another two, and their lead now is 20 points. Mullings spots Joey King. Joey King in the interference. Here he is again. It's going to hit off the backboard, at which point you can't do anything with the defense, and Klamenko went up there and interfered with it. So that gets it back to 18, but Kataya Basket need. Minrath gets it to Zubcic, who turns, puts it up, and just shoots. That's a quiet 8 points for Zubcic. Now the three-pointer, no good. And going up in attempt to rebound was Tomi Uolila, but all he could do was knock it away. Astapkovic has come into the game, number 7 for Aftador, who right now are cruising. Minerath gets in low, puts it up, and powers his way up and over King. Ranico hands it off. Sepala gives it back to Ranico. Now Sepala inside, and well, Uolila needs to do better. Ranico for three. Good strong rebound from Mullings. He puts it up and in. Minerath. And I think we're going to have a charge. For a minute there, I thought we might have some simulation or diving. But there was definitely contact. So Beard gets the charge. Here was Mullings hustling down the court. This was Frazier nailing the three. .138 remaining, 20-point game. Ranico, oh, Mullings has it stolen, but then Ranico gets it right back from Kolyushkin. So Kolyushkin had what he did to somebody else done to him. Look, he jumps up, takes it away, and takes it out, tries to make the pass, and Ranico read the pass beautifully and took it. Well, it was an important foul because it put Ranico on the line and he makes the first. Both teams in the bonus right now. So shooting free throws the rest of the way on fouls. Ranico makes both. Hits it back to Zubcic. Now inside to Minrath. And Kataya Basket had him surrounded, but committed the foul. And it was Mullings. Headley comes back into the game, number 23. Sepela also in the game, number 24, King. Uolila, number 8 in that rebounding position. Also, Vranić is in the game. So Minerath makes the first and the second. And Minerath's having a pretty good game so far. Those numbers keep going up. Vranico. Sepela. And drills a three. So Sepela puts it back to a 17-point deficit. Frazier out of the perimeter. It's online, but it was short. And then Frazier, the long rebound, bounced right to him. And bizarrely, he just didn't catch the ball. So a break for Kataya Basket. Sepela over to Randico for three, and that was short. And Koliushkin grabs the rebound. And Bradley reaches in and fouls. Koliushkin will go to the free throw line, so not a good foul. Koliushkin makes the first and the second. Well, Aftador will not want Kataya Basket to hold it until the end, but they may have to let him. Sepela has it. Coming up on the 10-second mark. Sepela, bounce pass to Ronico. Beautiful play from Kataya Basket. And the long shot is too long. So Aftador have opened up a big lead, and they're still on top by a big number. They lead by 17 going to halftime against Kataya Basket. Well, we're at halftime, and as you look at the numbers, they're much better for Aftador. 80% inside the arc. That is quite incredible. And not only that, they've hit 5 three-pointers at 41%. So with 56 points already, Aftador on their way to putting up a big number tonight here in Russia. Minerath has the 11 points for Aftador, and you can see King with 10 points. 10 points leading the way for Kataya Basket. Stick around for second half action, folks. We will be right back here in Saratov, Russia, for this resumption of the Group B game between Aftador Saratov and Kataya Basket of Finland.
Матча. 4, команда «Фалау» катает баскет.
Well, if the scoreboard doesn't make for pretty viewing right now for the fans of Catalia Basket, their team trails 54-37 at Aftador Saratov, a team going for its second consecutive win in the Basketball Champions League in Group B. They won at BC Chemic last week, and they'll be looking to avoid the sort of second half performance that allowed BC Chemic to claw their way back and make a game of it. BC Chemic ended up losing that game by just 3 points and had a chance to knot it and send it to overtime, but Aftador Saratov held on. And now Catalia Basket, who lost last week, a team that had to come through qualifying just to make it into the regular season, they are in danger of slipping to 0-2 unless they turn things around. And their coach Greg Gibson will be looking for the team to have a good start here in the third quarter. That first few minutes, first 5 minutes, always critical for a team, especially that's trailing big like Catalia Basket. And they actually trailed worse in this game. They were behind by as many as 22 points. That was late in the second quarter. So they've been able to cut that deficit back just a little. But they've still got some work to do. Interestingly, Aftador Saratov have really bossed the paint. They've got 24 of their points inside in the paint. Let's hear what Coach Gibson has to say. I think obviously what really has to concern Catalia Basket more than anything else is that they've allowed Aftador Saratov go out and shoot almost 81% from the floor inside the arc and 45.45% from three-point range. So that is the quarter-by-quarter scoring, and we're about ready to start things off here in the second half. Well, good evening. Welcome back to the game, folks. If you've had a little break, it's Aftador Saratov on top 56-39 over Catalia Basket. And Byron Wesley drives in and gets things going here for Catalia Basket. But then no defense at all from Catalia Basket to stop Aftador Saratov just making a layup. And Carrera now has 9 points. Well, the hustle, but Michael Stockton comes away with it. He gets it over to Brandon Frazier. Only white shirts going up for that ball. Now Michael Stockton, bounce pass. And Klamenko took a while, but he finally went up and made the shot. Klamenko with 4 points. Mullings penetrates back to Nino Johnson, and Nino Johnson gets the foul from Klamenko. So trailing by 19 points, Catalia Basket go to the line, and Nino Johnson makes the first.
Nino Johnson.
Hey, Nino Johnson only able to get that deficit back to 60-42. And Nino Johnson reaches up and prevents the pass. Now out on the break, gets it over to Wesley. And then Wesley appealed for a foul. And I think he may have had a point there. Frazier gets it to Klemenko. Klemenko then tries to pass it back to Frazier. Oranico. And Mullings on the baseline. Stockton, three-pointer. And the lefty takes it back up to 19, the lead for Aftador. And now the give and go. And Mullings tries to throw it off of Stockton, but Stockton was waiting. Now the pass to Klemenko. And the alley-oop gives Aftador a 21-point advantage. They are just right now kind of on cruise control. And Wesley then thought he was throwing to Ronico, but in fact he was throwing it to the referee. Stockton drives in. Lost it out of bounds, but say that the Kataya basket player knocked it out of bounds. This is week two of the Basketball Champions League. And Minerath puts it up and in. Well, one thing about Minerath is he's going to get his points. There's no doubt about it. Takes it. This lead just keeps getting bigger and bigger. Ronico. Now quickly for an easy one. And Stockton just races ahead of the defense. And Coach Greg Gibson is not going to be a happy coach over here on the sidelines. Look at Frazier again, spotting Stockton, who got up ahead of that Kataya defense. Well, Kataya Basket really have their work cut out for them to try to get back into this one. You can see they are down by a big number, 25 points. And what has to be worrying is their defense. They have just been anonymous. That three-pointer falls for Joey King, so that'll help. Gets it back to 22. Klemenko into Minerath, and Klemenko misses. The ball batted out to Ronico. Now up ahead to Mullings. Wesley thinks about it. It was baseline. Now Nino Johnson, five on the shot clock, puts it up. He had the move, couldn't quite finish. Now he's got it back, but fumbles the ball out of bounds. Zubcic comes back into the game for Avtodor Saratov. And easy one for Brandon Frazier, just kind of floats into the lane and lays it up and in. Pass goes inside, and a foul called on Frazier. So Makalainen was able to get position. Wesley over to Ronico. Ronico looks at the ref to say he was hit, but he walks back after shooting an air ball. Frazier for three. Well, you have to think that the 100 mark is well within reach for Avtodor tonight. They're up 74-47. Bounce pass to Ronico. And then he was creamed by Michael Carrera. Well, Carrera just went up for the block. Frazier comes out of the game. Koliushkin back in. Ronico makes the first. He's got 8 points and misses the second. Plesnikov also in the game for Avtodor Saratov. Well, he went down like a sack of wheat, did Zubcic. And Ronico, even though he wrapped him up, didn't look like he bumped him that badly. But he went over to see if he was okay. Koliushkin into Carrera, and nobody there to stop Kolesnikov. But Kitai Basket just have some real defensive deficiencies that they're going to have to work on. They have been picked apart quite easily tonight. I don't know if it's confusion or more of a matter of effort, but we haven't seen it. Well, the one shot and out goes back to Minarath and Avtodor. And again, that was an easy one that was missed. Sepala just is going to allow the layup. And now Sepala loses it out of bounds. Zabelin coming into the game. He was impressive in the first half. Another layup and a three-point play opportunity. Zabelin right off the bench will now walk to the line. A little bit of a size issue on that one. Zabelin just catches it, turns, and shoots. Free throw is good. So now it's 79-48. Look at that, 31 points coming off the bench for Saratov to just 12 for Kataya. Pump fake from King, and the jump shot is good. Kolesnikov hands it off, and Zubcic shows that range. 82-50. And Zubcic now with a quiet 9 points. Sepala hands it off to Makalainen. And Makalainen is going to put it up in the end, and it's going to be rebounded by Bradley, and this time Sepala drills it. So Kataya content to just trade baskets at this stage, it seems. Same with Aftador Saratov. Kolyushkin. Zubcic again. And the big fella has got some range, folks. Look at that. That was his 3-point celebration. The shake of the three fingers. He's got 12 points. He's nailed a couple of threes. And Bradley gets inside and powers his way up for two. Well, Zabelin played for Aftador Saratov from 2003 through 2007. Then he went to Chemik Inglis, then to CSKA Moscow from 2007 to 2011. In fact, he was from 2004 through 2005, he was with Chemik. So on loan, I guess you'd say, even though Aftador Saratov owned his rights. There's the drive from Sepala. That was good. Zabelin then went to Lokomotiv Kuban, Spartak Primorye, Krasny Krylia, and here he is back at Aftador Saratov. Still only 28 years of age. Another reach and the foul by Bradley. Oh, Greg Gibson has his work cut out for him. Get some improvement out of this team. That 3-point shot was good from Zubcic. So he's now up to 15 points. Not a bad night's work when you consider how many minutes he's played tonight. And now turnover. Getting a bit sloppy the game. So Zubcic has played 14 and a half minutes, and he's got 15 points. Zabelin was bumped by Sepala. So Sepala with the foul. Zabelin not happy with it. He was hoping to go up for a dunk. He played for Russia's junior national teams, but not so far for the senior national team. It's not too late. Nice soft release there at the free throw line for Zabelin.
Четыре команды
Nice penetration drive, the foul. However, called on Astatkovic. We'll put the Finnish team on the line. They've got him on the left arm on the way down. At least for Kataja Basket, they're not going to give up 100 points by the end of the third quarter. There's only 14 seconds remaining here in this quarter. Miss, but the ball is back with Sepela, and Kataja will have the last shot, they hope. Sepela gets inside, goes right at Zabelin, and scores. So good finish. There for Sepela and for Kataja Basket, but they're still trailing 30 points heading to the last quarter. The Saratov shooting hasn't gotten any worse, that's for sure. Still at 80% and 55% inside the arc, 55% beyond it. Look at that, 27 assists for Aftador to just 10 for Kataja. There's the quarter-by-quarter scoring. It's Aftador Saratov on top, 90-60 over Kataja Basket from Finland. So the Russians right now just really laying the wood to this team, wearing the blue and looking as if they will improve to 2-0. Kataja Basket were beaten last week, so they are in all likelihood going to be staring at an 0-2 hole unless something incredible happens here in the fourth quarter. Bradley on the baseline, hits the jump shot. Well, maybe that's the start of a comeback. And Kolesnikov misses the jumper. Makalainen. Now Sepela from the line follows up his miss. And good offensive rebound from Makalainen, and he earns a trip to the line. He was fouled by Kolesnikov. But even the free throw stays out. At the free throw line tonight, Kataja Basket were just 50% before that, so now two more makes leaves them at 50. And the jump shot good from Kolesnikov, the three. And the next, he's got 11 points. So Zeppela drives in, tried to make a pass on the interior, and it's going to be Brandon Frazier. He triggered the break, and now just 3 points away from the century mark for Aptador Saratov. Mäkeläinen, nice arc on that shot for the Finn. Frazier gets it inside to Zubcic, who just kind of turns, puts it up with his left hand. He is just a scoring machine. 17 points. Seven of eight from the floor, Zubcic. It's incredible. He's leading him in scoring again, just like last week. Now the turnover, and Zubcic has it, gets it to Minerath, and nice little play there from Niemi. Yes, and Niemi knocks it away. And Niemi fouled by Kolesnikov.
Евгений Колесников, номер 24-й, команда «Автодор», 4-й фол. Замену «Автодора» на площадке Майкл Каррера.
So, fourth foul for Kolesnikov, and he comes out of the game. Mäkeläinen. And he drew iron there, and then Bradley boxes out well, gets the ball back. And the pass over to Seppela, and the three-pointer falls, 99-69. It's a 30-point deficit, just under 7 minutes remaining. Frazier kicks it, Carrera. Gets it to Minerath. And Minerath turns, elevates, and scores. Nice pass inside, but Niemi doesn't finish. Now Zubcic. The front of the rim. Seppela brings it back for Kataya. Ulila. Back to Seppela, and Seppela steps out of bounds, turns it back over. What you call an unforced turnover. 16 in the game for Kataya basket. So Zubcic comes out. Here's the applause. And coming in for him is the big fella, Makiev. And here's Makiev right off the bench and lost control of it. Wesley penetrates. Nino Johnson. Well, Nino wasn't ready for the pass, and then he made a bad pass to turn it over, and Minerath tried to entertain the crowd. I think he still did, even though he missed it. Now Seppela hits a two, had his right foot on the line. Carrera goes up against Nino Johnson, turns it over. You saw Minerath thought he was going to get another alley-oop pass to throw down. He did, but he just threw it off the back of the rim. And Johnson's pass batted, and another easy one for Frazier. So midway through the fourth quarter, and Aptador Saratov already passed the century mark, and no telling how many points they'll score. Thank you. Group B here as Kataya take the timeout. Kataya will, in all likelihood, slip to 0-2 along with Kimmich and CSM CSU Oradea from Romania, Kimmich from Ukraine, and Le Mans, Maccabi Ran Media, Pinar Karciak, or Le Mans and Maccabi Ran Media will be up at the top with Athador Saratov. All with two wins. Romano Raya Venezia are 1-1, as well as Pinar Karciaka after their interesting encounter last night that the Italians won. Some of the other teams making names in this competition. Ike Athens, boy, they've been impressive so far in their start to the Basketball Champions League. Here's Minerath again. Scrap for the ball, goes out of bounds over to the Russians. Neptūnas Klaipėda from Lithuania. They've won their first two games in Group C. It's a pretty even group. PAOK bounced back from their triple overtime defeat to win last night a close one against Moritbe Ušak Sportiv. And the turnover into the hands of Carrera. Carrera hands it off to Minerath. And now Wesley has it going the other way for Kataya basket. Hands it off. And nice finish from Bradley with the reverse layup. Stockton. And find it ever so easy to Makiev. 105 to 73, his first two. Now Carrera playing hard. Almost comes up with the steal. Now just 8 on the shot clock. And Wesley gets it over to Bradley. Makiev with the board. And Stockton has to chase it back. Tonoyan has come into the game, number 30 for Athador. And he's got the ball. He's going to launch it. Draws the back of the iron. Bradley, or Nino Johnson. Back to Sepala. And Sepala makes the three. It'll probably be hard to top the combined number of points from this game. It's a big scoring game. You see field goals, Saratov. Athador now down to 76%, so their percentage has dropped. Two on the shot clock. Stockton gets it off just in time, but doesn't get any iron, so it goes back over to Kataya. Traveling was called before Bradley's dunk. Stockton dribbles it, gives it over to Makiev. Carrera. box out was there, but he kind of gave away at the end, and Tonoyan ended up with the easiest of bank shots. Tonoyan, just 18 years of age, so this is a big stage for him, playing in the Basketball Champions League here, even though he's getting mop-up duty. Minute and a half remaining. Behind-the-back pass from Johannes Lasarov, and Bradley buries the three-pointer. Pertu in the game, number seven. And Makiev has his way down low. 109-79. And we've got a minute to go here in this Group B game. There's no way to sugarcoat it, folks. It's been a good old-fashioned blowout. Ante Pertu pops a three-pointer. So Lasarov, 21-year-old, picks up the foul. Tonoyan passes back to Makiev. Well, Makiev is cleaning up here. Takes it up to a 111-82 lead, and showing a nice touch for the big fella. Another traveling call against Bradley. So the final 20 seconds, mercifully coming to an end here for Kataya Basket. And Tonoyan's fouled. .7 seconds remain. Stockton feeds Carrera. Now Carrera turns into his left and tries to bull his way. Oh, gotta be something going on. They're gonna give him an and-one. Thought maybe there was a travel. Well, they definitely also got fouled there. What was it called? I was wondering if there might be a 3 seconds. But in the end, Carrera earns his trip to the free throw line. Zabelin had a good time on the left there, didn't he? Coming off the bench tonight. And Carrera misses the free throw. But one last time, chance for Kataya Basket. Bradley goes up and draws the foul. Sergei Mokin, not sure what he can learn really from this game. And it's for Kataya Basket. Certainly, they're going to have to make a lot of improvement. They're going to do something in this tournament. Greg Gibson's got to get him back out on the practice court. We'll go over some things, because they are big losers today, falling 113-84. Well, I don't know what you thought about Aftador Saratov before the season, but they have won their first two games in the Basketball Champions League. They've followed up their opening week win at Kimmich with a win over Kataya Basket here in Group B, 113-84. So the percentages probably would have been a lot better if they hadn't taken their foot off the pedal there in the fourth quarter, but they still shot 74% at the door inside the arc and 52% beyond it. 34 assists to 17 for Kataya Basket. And Kataya turned it over 22 times. Sepala ended up with a game-high 20 points for Kataya. And Nicholas Minerath doing his part as a basketball player, taking the team photos. Everybody wants to get their photos with a winner. And now he's going to sign some autographs. So it's going to be a long flight back home for the team from Finland. Whereas for Aptator Saratov, they're going to sit down and have a nice team talk in the locker room before heading off, no doubt, for a nice dinner. They've earned it. They are now unbeaten in the Basketball Champions League with two wins in as many games.